Jay Shrek, myths, lies, and legends. You wouldn't believe where we're at today. We're at a little town about 3.5 miles from the border of Mexico in Ruby, Arizona. Now, Ruby is famous for being probably the best preserved town, ghost town that is, in Arizona. And it's pretty fabulous. And I'll tell you what, we weren't expecting to see this here. Now, in this location, they're famous for the Mexican bats, right? They have 150 to some say 300 to 500,000 bats that come here between April normally and then leave in September. And they fly out of here and they say that when they come out of this hole that the sky's black for 40 minutes. There's that many. And there we just saw. That is an unbelievable hole right there. I'm telling you, that is unbelievable. Now, if you go over here, there's another shaft also. Now, Ruby was a main gold and silver producer, and it had a long history. Now, this area was founded by the Spanish in the 1700s. So this was worked 220 years ago. So in 1700, the Spaniards came through here and they worked it for a while. And then it was worked again in the 1850s. Tell you, we're in the schoolhouse right now. Now, at the height of the school, there was 150 students here, and just had two birds come through here, scared the holy hell out of me. Before the school, in the 40s, which pretty much everybody left after the ore ran out. The original condition. So, So there you go. If you take an adventure down here to Ruby, then guess what? Showers. Looks like showers, I'm guessing. Slide of death, as we call it. So how'd they take care of business back in the olden days, right? So the 1900s, 1800s, 1900s, early 1900s. Basically what they did was they just chained you to a tree. So you'd just be chained to a tree. So in 1936, what they did was they decided they needed a jail. So they built a jail. And the jail cost $600 to build. And here it is. It's pretty heavy duty stuff. So they didn't heat it, they didn't cool it. So basically that's what you got. And then they would take you from Nogales, from here to Nogales. So that was their destiny in the Wild Wild West. So let's talk about the most infamous building in Ruby, right? There's one building that is more important to the history, the brutal history. So if you'll see those very doors right there, see that door right there. Now, what made this building so haunted? The thing that most people don't know is that this building was supposedly built on the grave of a padre. And so when that happened, the curse or the rumor was that anybody built on this ground, it was going to be bad. So in 1920, two brothers were running this store. And a band of Villistas. Now, Villista was a Pancho Villa groups, right? That was one of their crew, right? Their desperados came into this store, and they walked through these very doors. And that's when all hell broke loose. You know, it's funny about the Old West. One thing about the Old West that's really kind of intriguing to me is that, you know, we just got done doing the Oatman Massacre. Now, the first thing that those Indians wanted, right, from the Oatman family was tobacco. And isn't that funny that the first thing that the Mexicans asked for was tobacco. So that must have been a pretty hot commodity back in those days. Now, those Mexicans shot both of those clerks. One died pretty close to instantly. The other had a bullet hole through his eye. And he lived about 5 hours before he died. Now they hunted for those Mexicans across the border. Now, if you look in that direction, there,
up over those hills.
Up over those hills would be where the Mexicans would go back to Mexico, right? 3.5 miles from the border across that those ridge right there. Now they hunted forever for those Mexicans.
But to no avail. And so therefore, 14 months later, a family came into town. And you know, they had their eye on that mercantile. And they thought, you know what? I think we'll buy it. Because they didn't believe at that point that 14 months later, the same thing could happen to them as happened to the Fraser brothers. They didn't find it would even be possible, right? But Frank and Myrtle Pearson purchased that mercantile. Now, they'd been told, do not purchase this mercantile. Because one of the mysteries about that was that when they built that mercantile in 1880, that was built on a Padre's grave. And they stated that anything that was built on that Padre's grave would be cursed. But the Pearsons didn't believe that that was even possible, right? Because what could happen like happened before? Could that happen again? What are the odds, right? Very minimal, right? You would think the odds of the same situation happening twice. Another desperados that came through those same doors as the seven came through before. Martinez and Silva, those two Mexican gentlemen.
Well, they shot the husband and they went after Margaret, the small girl. But as the mother was screaming, Silva noticed that she had gold teeth, right? So he let the girl go, basically, and went after the mother. And what he did is truly bloody and gory. He knocked her teeth out with the butt of his gun and then killed her. What happened after that was the largest manhunt in the state of Arizona ever. 700 men chased those two outlaws. They even brought a biplane in from Nogales, right? Wow. And they chased those outlaws night and day, and for 7 days, and they finally caught those two outlaws, and they took them to justice. And those two outlaws were supposed to hang, and one of the most incredible things happened, right? On the way to Florence, taking the prisoners up there, there was a mighty crash, right? And that cop car rolled over, and those two deputies ended up dead. Now, they're said that they jumped out of the car, and somehow that caused that car to roll over, but they were also bludgeoned with a tool. And so another two men lost their lives hunting down the Martinez and Silvas gang. Another massive manhunt, right? And so they collect these two. They finally find them again, right? And they take them to prison. Now, Martinez, his fate and justice was served at the end of a rope. Silva escaped and was never heard of again. Now, so whether that is the legend of Ruby and that mercantile being built on that haunted ground, I don't know. But it makes for an interesting story. Now, if you get a chance to go to Ruby, one of the things you're gonna find out is the most complete town in Arizona, ghost town that is. And it's a wonderful place to wander around.